Drunken barkeep saves rake factory. Still think I'll turn the town into a smoking crater?
Okay, now in my imagination, there's no smoke.
No smoke.
That's progress.
And notice she didn't make an explosion sound. Of course she's gonna do it once I bring it up.
This is good. We've got people's attention. Now we just need to point out your good qualities.
Right. Any ideas?
Well, let's start with this. How'd you pull this off?
I just told them that once I become mayor, I'll change the town's slogan to Canada's Rake City.
Oh.
And we got a tweak Founders Day parade.
Rake Day parade?
Yeah. And I sort of promised we'd ban leaf blowers, but mostly he just wanted to be listened to and drink free beer.
You see, that could be our slogan.
Free beer. Great idea.
No, no, the listening part.
Huh?
Damn. He's a bartender. He knows how to listen. You see? When you shut up and start listening, you make a good candidate.
Nice. Hey, did you know there's 18 types of rakes? The tines are...
Yeah, yeah, I remember the shut up part.
It's always a pleasure to talk to a small businessman. Woman, I mean, I believe both sexes can be businessmen.
Right. So this bartender who is running against you, Dan.
Don't worry about him.
Well, as a businesswoman or businessman, as you'd say, I am worried that he might get in.
Won't happen.
He did save the rake factory. And this new slogan...
I'm getting my own slogan, too. Bud Calgrove, change you can believe in.
But you're the status quo.
Status quo you can believe in. Oh, and none of this would be happening without this guy, huh?
Mm. Hey, buddy. Here is the man.
Mike here's the guy that figured out that if Bud wins, we win.
To be fair, it was actually my fiancée, Claire, who figured it out, which is kind of ironic.
Oh, how so?
Well, she used to date Dan.
Oh.
Yeah, Claire has horrible taste in men.
Hey, way to save the rake factory, man.
Oh, thanks.
Good job, Dan. You made the city proud.
Would you get out of here?
Fine. I'm leaving.
Hey.
Hey.
Can I get a decaf?
Sure.
Are you sure that's decaf?
Yeah, it's decaf.
Because normally it has an orange.
It's decaf. I just brewed it.
Okay. Hey, by the way, nice job with the rake factory. I didn't know you had it in you.
You know I'm gonna go down to City Hall and pitch Rake Day.
Good.
You should come down and watch.
Oh, I don't know if I can.
Or not. I mean, it doesn't matter.
I have a yoga class.
Yeah, yeah, no, it's cool.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I don't. I mean, if you hadn't lit a fire under me, I would have never talked to the rake guy, so I kind of owe you.
No, you don't. Really. I should go. Are you sure it was.
It was decaf.
Hey, Dano.
Yeah.
This poster here.
Yes, Fern, I'm running for mayor. That's why I put up the poster, because I'm running for mayor of Wessex.
I know. You won't shut up about it. Oh. Next time, mention Ferns, okay? Dan, he's a bartender at Ferns. He knows how to listen.
Will do.
It's a simple thing.
What are you doing here?
Thought I'd offer some support. Plus, I wasn't in the mood for yoga. Too jittery for some reason.
Oh, well, thanks for coming.
You're welcome.
Nice outfit.
Dan, I wanted to talk to you. I think this city needs a real mayor.
Well, Anita...
In Dan's defense, he did stop Mr. Robinson from moving his factory.
I'm sorry, you are...
I'm Claire Kendall. Oh, the outfit, yeah. I was gonna go to yoga, and then I thought I had some decaf that wasn't decaf, and I couldn't relax, and now I'm talking too much, and then I thought I should come down and support Dan because we used to date.
Oh, you're the woman with bad taste in men that's engaged to Mike.
I wouldn't say bad taste.
Aren't you the one that figured out Alan Duffy could run against him? That's what I heard.
What?
Well,
I guess this is a bad time, sorry.
You told him to run attack him?
Dan, you have to understand, that was before. I didn't think that...
That I'm a grown-up? That I could get a job done?
Hey, guys, look what I made. Got listen?
I can't do this.
Uh-oh. I did 500 of these.
On a personal note, it is unfortunate that I'm forced to run under Bud Calgrove's name, but Seeing as my opponent refuses to do the right thing and step aside, I have no choice. Now, first item. We need a pedestrian crossing light in front of City Hall.
Excuse me, I'd like to say something.
No, that's not really part
Thanks.
Of...
Thanks. I thought I could just walk in here and become mayor. I mean, everyone said I should quit. Even the one person I should be able to count on the most. My ex-girlfriend. That's why I'm dropping out of the race. And that's why, once the race is open to everybody, I want to put my name back in. I do intend to be mayor of this city, but I'm going to earn it. Together, we'll make Wessex not only the best raked city in Canada, but the best raked city in the world.
He doesn't stand a chance now, does he?
Against living people? No.
Thanks. Oh, there was a $1,000 entrance fee. I don't have to pay that again, do I?
This is gonna be a lot tougher now. 5 candidates so far, and a joke candidate.
For the last time, I'm not a joke candidate.
Not you, the guy in the unicycle.
Wheelo's a joke candidate?
I'm very happy. This city deserves a real election.
I hope I can count on your support.
I don't think so. I'm running against you.
What? You are?
Well, this city deserves the best, not just the best of a bad lot.
Best of a bad lot? That's a swipe at me.
No, she meant me.
That's a swipe at both of you. You're the bad lot.
Oh, right. But I'm the best.
Excuse me, can I get a picture of the candidates?
I can't believe I'm not in the photo.
Why would you be in the photo?
I'm running for mayor.